The Minister of State for Kampala, Kawiye Chofatogabie, accompanied by the State House Comptroller Jane Bareche, the Gomba Woman MP Silivia Nayebare, Central Buganda Bishop and the Board Chairperson of the affected school, Right Reverend Michael Lubowa, and the Gomba Resident District Commissioner Charles Lukoba Chasanku, plus management of Kasaka SS, visited the homes of the deceased children. They laid wreaths on the graves and handed over the condolence from the President. Speaking to families of the deceased students, Kawiye Chofatogabie said they're going to conduct a psychosocial support that includes counseling to students before school reopens.
When we saw a few of them, they need really counseling and comfort because this is an occurrence they had never experienced. And indeed, being young, the shock is inevitable. So we requested the bishop, who is actually the board chairperson of the school, to ensure that it takes through these young Ugandans or the teenagers into a counseling kind of process, session, so that people are comforted and then they are prepared to come to the school.
The families they visited included that of John Bosco Kayondo of Nsambwe, who lost his son John Bosco Mawanda, who was a student in Senior 2. Catherine Namare, the mother of Louis Semwanga, who was a student in Senior 4, and Simon Chagulanyi of Kasaka, the father of Eve Namagembe, who was a student in Senior 5. They later proceeded to Gomba Hospital, where 6 injured victims are currently receiving treatment, and handed over 1 million shillings to each family. The family members thanked the president for standing with them in this trying moment. The woman member of parliament for Gomba District, Livia Nayebare, thanked the president for standing with the families and the good gesture. She promised to mobilize more support for the school.
I'd like to thank His Excellency for the fatherly heart, for the caring heart, for the loving heart he has showed to the families of the deceased and to these ones that are still sick. So we are hoping that the ones who are still sick here at Gombe Hospital will heal positively, and we hope for God's mercy to heal them and they go back to school.
Earlier, before visiting the bereaved families, the Central Buganda Bishop, Michael Lubowa, took the team on a guided tour of the structure that was destroyed when the truck rammed into the school, which included the school computer laboratory and a classroom block. Bishop Lubowa asked the State House Comptroller and the minister to talk to the president and help them build the damaged structures and secure other computers for the school.
Kubanga anga RDC wayogedde ekyamazima kyetaaga okutuwaayo obudde obeera obaka memorandum ketuweereza nga tetupapa kubanga kati bino ebimu tuyinza okupapa wakana ebimu tebigenze buki
bulungi. Kino bwe kyatuusewo twebaza president okulaba nti bwe yatuusebwa ati mu ggwanga kyasookeddeko kubanga kyabadde kimulumye nnyo ng'abaana be abantu b'eggwanga bwe bafuna bulijjo bafuna ekizibu ky'ekisooka omuluma era ye president noza reactinga immediately ku muntu wa wansi. Ebintu bingi biba biri mu ggwanga naye bwe yatuuse bwati keyatusoose okwogera fe yatutumya butumi yatumye minisita nange timutwale amabugo gano mugatwalire abantu b'eggomba mugende mu ddwaliro mulabe abaana bwe bali mukomewo mu mbuulire atwatuuse na kati ku ssomero kuno kwe tuli tugenda kuzzaayo information tumubuulire status eri wano nsuubira really teri kimulema era ajja kuba nammwe nga bw'abadde nammwe.
On Tuesday afternoon, a Sino truck lost control and rammed into the perimeter fence of Kasaka Secondary School and crashed into the school computer laboratory before proceeding to a Senior 5 classroom block. 4 students died and 18 others were seriously injured. Yesterday, while addressing Parliament, President Museveni promised 5 million shillings as contribution to the families of students who died in this tragic incident and 1 million to each family of those that were injured and currently receiving treatment in different hospitals. Report compiled by Simon Sechide for the news.